Hello everybody, this is Srikant. So today I'm going to talk about how to create and activate the virtual environment for our Python 3 project in every shell or operating system. I can try. Okay. Here we have to create a Python project. I'm just going to name it py_the_project. Okay. Just create in there. Okay. As you can see, I open my project and I have to open it in a command line or terminal or shell, whatever you want. Okay. The command is something like this. Oh, wait, this is my blog post. Okay, I'm just gonna put this in description. The command is python minus m venv and then the venv. Normally it can be anything like this fourth part, which can be folder name of your virtual environment or venv. Normally it is venv, which is actually a folder, but I'm just gonna name it venv. Okay. You can name it whatever you want. It's not the mandatory to name as VEN. Okay. Now, in some old version of Windows or your other version of Python, if you're using multiple Python's version, you have to specify the version also. Like here, I'm using Python 3 minus VENV if you're using Python 2 also. But if you are using multiple Python 3 version, then you have to use Python 3.1, 3.2, like this. Okay. Okay. And in some Windows, there is also Py 3 and the Py, Py, minus M, VNV, and VNV, etc. Okay. The command will be for the Windows and the Py. Okay. Here, it created a folder of 22 MB for Windows. It creates a folder like 22 MB. Your device may have some other. Here it created a folder with the scripts as folder, as a subfolder, activate.bat, activate.ps1, deactivate. Okay, so to activate our command in the command line, the Windows command line, we have to open this activate.bat here. Run. Not the open, run. Wait a minute. I'm just gonna show you the code. Okay. I'm just gonna zoom in at here. Okay. As you can see here, backslash VNV / scripts and then activate.bat. We can also use without the .bat extension. It is not mandatory, but in most of the command line, it automatically suggests for the .bat. Okay. Okay. But if you are using the PowerShell instead of the command line, okay, PowerShell.exe. Okay. I have opened this project in the PowerShell, as you can see. Let's zoom in. Wait, I'm just gonna have to show you first. Okay. The PowerShell. The command is the same. /vnv/, then the scripts with capital S, then the activate, then .ps1. Okay. Capital A activate. C activated. Then the deactivate command for deactivating the virtual environment. But if you are using the third-party CLI, like GitHub Bash CLI, which is something like Unix-like shells or the CLI in Windows, so you have to run other command like SOURCEVEN, wait, the folder name, then the scripts, the capital S, then the small a. Not the here, you don't have to run the bat, only the activate. Okay, see, activated and deactivated. Wait a minute. And if you are using Linux based or the Mac OS, then you have to just replace that the script part with the bin, all small, all lowercase. I'm just gonna put this blog post link in my description if you want to read it.